Burası Ankara. Aziz dinleyiciler, haberler bültenimizi okuyoruz. Tarım Bakanlığı'ndan bildirildiğine göre, tarım aletleri mübayası için bakanlığa şimdilik 1.728.000 dolar tahsis edilmiştir.
In the spring sun, life grows busy again. The men are in the fields, leaving the village to the children and the women's work. School, the children too have work to do. Learning to read and write. Learning to count. But if they're going to be good farmers, they'll always be learning. Each day they'll be adding a piece more to what they already know. Made a start in life. Some may go straight back to their father's fields. Some may go to the farm school. For there are always new ideas about and new ways of doing things.
Burası Ankara. Aziz dinleyiciler, haberler bültenimizi okuyoruz. Tarım Bakanlığı'ndan bildirildiğine göre, Marshall yardımından tarım aletleri mübayası için bakanlığa şimdilik 1.728.000 dolar tahsis edilmiştir.
What have new ideas to do with a farmer? That was what most of them thought. There was enough to do without that. For farming on these plains is hard. The hills have lost their trees, and there is little shelter against the sun and the wind. The rain clouds are infrequent visitors, and the earth grows hard and dry. The grass only gives the cattle a meager feed. The shepherd must move out far beyond the village and comb the hills with his flocks. Here, the fruit of the soil is hard won. For generations, farmers have toiled with ox or horse and wooden plough to earn their bread. For generations, their methods and the tools they used have remained much the same. For change comes slowly to these unyielding lands. But Yusuf was a boy who had learnt new ideas. We could do better, Yusuf used to say to his father, Zechariah. They taught us at the farm school how much you could do with quite simple changes that don't cost a lot of money. Look at our wooden plough. Whether we use oxen or horses, it still only scratches the surface. It doesn't turn the soil and bury the weeds and give it the fertility it needs. But his father wouldn't listen. There's no time for talk while there's work to be done. And the spring ploughing went on through the silence of the day. But a week or so later, when all the men were gathered at the cafe in the evening, Yusuf had a new plan. He kept quiet at first and waited his chance. Then he tackled his father once more. Let me try working our old bit of pasture on the other side of the village with a metal turning plough, he said, and do it the way they taught us at the farm school. A metal plough won't cost a great deal. Let me try. Zechariah was silent, but the others said, let the boy have a go. You've nothing to lose. Yusuf looked at his father, and Zechariah thought, and then suddenly he said, yes, my son, you can try. We will get a metal plow. Yusuf raced off with delight down and through the village, making for the distant hills. For there lived Hasan Bey, the farm agent for their region. Yusuf had often talked with him when he came back from the farm school. Hasan Bey made him welcome. We want a metal plow, Yusuf said, and told him how his father had agreed at last to his plan. Hasan Bey was pleased and said he would give all the help he could. And he went through his papers and explained where the application should be made. Then he made out a certificate proving that Yusuf was a farmer so that he could go to the equipment depot and order his plow. And he wished the boy well. When Yusuf got back, he told his father that the plow would be coming, and Hasan Bey, the agent, had promised he would help him with other bits of equipment if he needed them. At the depot in Ankara, where equipment was assembled and made ready, they were busy with the day's orders, checking them off and loading each piece of equipment for dispatch. And Javed Bey, the district agricultural officer, was there, seeing that all the orders were dealt with in his area, for he was responsible for giving help and advice to farmers in a score and more of villages. And some wanted a new metal plow, and some had money to buy a tractor. But every farmer wants to get the best use out of the equipment he already has. And that was Javed Bey's job too. And that day, the plow for Yusuf and his father was loaded with the rest. It was an exciting week for Yusuf, waiting for the lorry to arrive, waiting for his chance to start. Then at last the lorry came, and with it came Hasan Bey and Javed Bey, and his father made them welcome. But they had other villages to visit, and as time was short, they got busy with the unloading. There it was, new and strong, a metal plow. Straight away next day, when the sun was up, Yusuf began work on the old strip of pasture. His father and some of his father's friends came to see him start, but their eyes were still critical and cold. But he plowed through the day, and the furrows grew and increased as the turning earth piled up behind the bright blade of the plow. And that day and every day after plowing, Yusuf went over the ground with a simple homemade harrow, so that the sun would have no chance of drying the lumps of moist soil into hard clods. Then for a time, the village forgot about Yusuf. There were other things to do. His father had village affairs to discuss with the Mukhtar, and the year went by. And when the time came, Yusuf started seeding. And instead of seeding by hand, which is wasteful and slow, Hassan Bey, the farm agent, lent him a simple seed drill, which is quicker and distributes the seed in the right amount and sets it at the right depth. And the others watched again. But the land is slow to show results. But one day, Hassan Bey came to see how Yusuf was progressing and brought with him Javed Bey. They looked at the wheat. And with the passing months, it already promised well. Six, seven, 8 years to one seed. The promise was good. And Hassan Bey explained what Yusuf had done with the old strip of pasture. Then harvest time came and went with much labor in the fields. Some of the crops were meager, but Yusuf's was among the best. And Yusuf worked on his own strip and helped his father getting in the wheat and the barley for the threshing. But it was only after the harvest that Yusuf's triumph was complete. He had got a good crop and good seed too. Even his father was impressed. And while the seed and Yusuf's work was being debated and discussed, Hassan Bey and Javed Bey arrived in their cart. They had told Yusuf that they would come to the village after the harvest and talk to the farmers. For Yusuf's example was of interest to the whole village, and he examined the results and praised Yusuf for his work. Proper use of one's land is one of the first things to think about, Javed Bey said. It is bad to plough the same piece of land year in, year out. Land needs change and rest too. After wheat or barley or oats, it is well on this land to lay fallow in alternate years. Yusuf used a bit of old pasture and he got good results. For pasture too gets poor if it is always grazed without rest. There are many things a farmer can do to ease his toil and improve his yields without having to spend a great deal of money. And then Hassan Bey talked about the simple changes in equipment a farmer can make. A metal plow or a seed drill, which Yusuf had used. And if a farmer wanted bigger equipment, like a Marshall Plan tractor, but found it too expensive, then several of them might get together and jointly buy and use the new tools they needed. This was the kind of thing he could help them with. He was there to give advice when the farmer wanted it. And when Hassan Bey had finished talking, Zechariah thanked him and said, maybe there was something to be learnt after all. And Yusuf knew that he had won his point. For learning only begins at school. There are always new ideas about and new ways of doing things. For the farmer, they can mean a great deal. The proper use of land to preserve its fertility and make it yield its fruits in full. The better use of tools. These things alone can begin to ease the farmer's toil and raise the output of his fields. And to his home and village, these things too mean greater opportunities. They are the tokens of prosperity. They are the foundations on which to build tomorrow's plans.